Welcome to Jesse Fit Pilates, your home to get fit, toned, and flexible. Today we're going to be doing a strengthening Pilates dumbbell workout. If you're looking to up the intensity of your Pilates workout using just 2 or 3 pound weights, you're gonna love this workout. Let's strengthen, stretch, and smile together. If you like what you see, please subscribe and comment below and let me know what you wanna see in the future. Hey guys, let's get started for our next beginner Pilates workout. Thank you for coming and showing up. And let's just go ahead and start with a nice deep breath in and lift your spine and then flatten it, right? Just lift it, flatten it, right? What we call imprinting, arching, imprinting, arching, and now find that neutral spine, right? We're going to keep that pelvis heavy, that natural curve in the lower back. Bring your legs up to your table position, and we're going right into our hundreds, right? So start by pumping the arms. If you can, lift your chest. Keep hollowing out your stomach. If you can, maybe extend one leg up and then the other to that. You can always keep the knees bent or the head down. And inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. And exhale, my legs are parallel. You can bend the knees, remember, or keep them straight. That'll be harder. Try to keep that neutral spine position. And exhale, breathing in, breathing out. Keeping the shoulders away from my ears. Lower belly really active. And exhale, one more time, breathing in and breathing out. I'm going to fold in for just a second. And then I'm going to sit right up. I'm going to press my feet down really firmly into the mat. Bend my knees. Knees are about hip width distance apart. I'm going to lift up for just a second here and raise my arms forward. You can always keep your hands on the legs to modify. We're going to roll down and then roll up and sit tall. Shoulders back onto the spine, away from the ears. Draw the belly in, lengthen the spine, exhale down. One vertebra at a time, touches. Heels stay pressing into the mat. Inhale, lengthen. And again, exhaling down. Inhaling up, keep your knees parallel and both sides of your heels really pressing into the mat. Taking it back a little bit further to making it a little bit more hard, more challenging. And then maybe taking it all the way back, reaching the arms back, getting that lat stretch there, coming through that neutral spine position. I'll curl up and lift and back down. Remember, you can always take the hands there. Stretching back, hands and head up. Inhale, coming up. Exhale. And inhaling down. Exhale to stretch. And inhaling up and exhaling back. And then maybe you can straighten the legs, making it a little bit more challenging. And reaching forward, stretching, anchoring the feet down, articulating through the low back, middle back, upper back, through neutral, and reaching to stretch the arms back. You can always stay with those knees bent and just take a deeper stretch. We'll do 5 more. Inhale and exhale on up, and inhale and exhale on back. Really engaging the core, anchoring the legs down, stabilizing the pelvis and the lower body, stretching the upper body, using the breath, using your core. 2 more times. Inhale and exhale on that up, and inhale and exhale on that down. From here, let's go ahead and bring our legs back to our table position. And then extend the legs up. And keep a flat back today. So let's just keep a flat back. Remember, we don't want to lift the tail, just to keep the lower back protected today, since some of us are just starting on that Pilates journey. Take a hold of one calf and let the other calf sink. Bring it up. Switch. really being mindful to keep that lower back on the mat. And now think about flexing through the toes and really stretching that up leg, really bracing the abs around the spine. And then finally, if you want to do the chest lift, and here's the rhythm, pull, pull, switch, pull, pull, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, maybe dropping it a little bit deeper, or really keeping that flat back today. Not letting the tailbone lift though as I lift the legs, keeping that tailbone down for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let your legs come in for just a second. Let your neck rest. You can look from right to left. And now let's scoop our hands behind the nape of our necks. Neck is really long, collarbones are wide, flat low back, really scooping, scooping, scooping the belly. Now extend the legs and try to keep the heels together and the toes apart. Keeping that flat back, lower your legs and then raise. Try not to tense much in the chest. Try to keep the lower belly bracing around the spine. The lower you go, the harder it is. You can modify with bent knees, that'll make it a little bit easier. Straight legs will definitely be harder. Smaller will be easier. Bigger will be harder. Now finally curl your head up. Control the way down. Control the way up. Exhale. Inhale, find the distance, find the range of motion that's right for you. Really feel those lower abs burning. Four more. Try not to lift the tailbone. I just did on that last rep. Last one. Awesome, guys. Go ahead, fold your knees in, rest your neck down. And then from here, let's go ahead and keep your hands behind your head, actually. Go back to that single leg stretch motion, twist to one side, and then twist to the other side and extend the other leg. Rotate to your right as you stretch the left leg away. Rotate to your left as you stretch the right leg away. I'm really trying to keep my torso still. You can come up higher to make that harder. Last, 8, 7. Try to avoid rocking on the pelvis. Try to keep your elbows open. Try to think about twisting from the ribs or the waist. Last, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go ahead and shoot the legs forward. Anchor your feet down. Lift your head on up to your chest. You can use your arms to help you. And come on up. Let's open our legs to mat width distance apart. Let's sit up as tall and as straight as we can. Reach the hands forward and flex your toes. Exhale, stretch the spine forward. You can tap down to the floor or to your shins if that's where you're at today. Inhale on up. Just try to keep the legs, the toes flexing. Exhale, forward, rounding the spine like you were sitting over a beach ball. Inhale up. And exhale, spine rounds. Inhale, it lengthens. Exhale. And inhale, really opening up the back of the thighs. Now let's go ahead and lay back. Shoot the legs back up now. Arms to your sides, shoulders stay down, and let's keep the legs a little straight as we can today, and just start with a little bit of that TikTok, moving your legs in one direction, bringing your vision to the opposite hand since the hands are in cross position, arms are out east-west, then you'll come to the center, and then I'm looking to my right as my legs go left. Center. And then if it feels right, you can try to extend the legs a little bit longer, maybe make it bigger, but always keeping those shoulders glued to the mat. So my hips are moving a little bit, but my shoulders, I'm really keeping those shoulder blades down. Honor where you're at today. Really working the sides of the waist, the obliques, And then go ahead and bend the legs in for just a second. And now from here, see if you can take the legs up, heels together, toes apart, draw a circle to the right. Let's actually bring the arms in. And then to the left on the ceiling. Keep your ribs really still, the hips will move. And then to the left, to the right, and to the left. Inhale and exhale for 8 and 7. Reaching those legs long, anchoring the hips down, keeping the ribs down, the chest open. And 4 and 3 and 2 and 1. I'm gonna have a sit on up. Reach for your toes. From here, cross at your ankles and come onto your belly. Take your hands about underneath your shoulders. Draw your elbows in. Keep the tops of the feet down on your mat and lengthen up. Belly draws in, belly does not even touch the mat. I'm really hollowing that belly out as if I was wearing a pair of jeans that were just a little bit too tight. And then lift on up. And then down. And a few more up, really opening the chest, drawing the elbows in. Inhale. Exhale, 4 more, engaging the upper back, gliding the shoulders away from the ears. And then finally, coming all the way up and just holding, drawing the abs in super tight. And finally coming down, sitting back into a child's pose, just stretching the hips back, keeping the abs really tight, drawing the belly muscles in. And then go ahead and come back down and reach your hands together with your elbows out east-west. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. Now, keep that feeling of the belly staying lifted. Try to have some sunlight peeking through your belly. Bring your feet together. Just lift your legs, keeping them long, and then lower and lift. It's going to be really small. Neck stays long, shoulders away from the ears. I'm trying to use the back of my thighs, lift my core for 8, 7, 6, 5, feeling the lower back and the glutes, 4, 3, 2, and we're gonna hold it and beat, squeeze, 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 8, 7, toes are pointed, 6, shoulders away from the ears, abs pulling in, bracing around my spine, for 4, 3, 2, and we're gonna sit back into a child's pose. And from here, we're gonna grab a set of weights. And we are gonna come to a cross-legged position. If that's not comfortable for you, you can always sit up on a yoga block or even a blanket or a pillow, just so that your knees are a little bit more open. They shouldn't be up to your ears. It shouldn't be particularly too uncomfortable. I mean, Pilates is never gonna be really comfortable, but you don't wanna feel like you're dying there. Lift your spine tall, draw your shoulder blades back, draw your belly muscles in. Now we're going to go and bring our arms up to the hug position, right? Hug a beach ball, draw the shoulders away from the ears. I'm gonna slightly tilt forward just so I'm not sitting back. And I'm gonna try to weight the knees down. I'm gonna pull the shoulder blades onto my spine. I'm gonna keep the collarbones open. I'm gonna open, but the angle at my elbow doesn't move, right? It stays the same. Hug a tree, right? Like a tree hugger, hippie. Hug a beach ball. Inhale. Exhale. I'm gonna keep squeezing those shoulder blades together onto my spine, opening my collarbones wide. Now, try not to flop the body forward and back. Try to keep the body in that slightly forward position. For 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now bring the elbows in. Come back forward. Draw the collarbones wide. Draw the abs in. Reach the arms back. Notice my shoulders stay back. Reach, bend, the higher you go, the harder this. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, just change the leg that's on top so we're not favoring one side. Come back to that server tray position. Come back to that slightly forward position. Now reach and hold. Bring the ends of the weights together as you bring your hands down. Then bend your elbows, extend. Elbows go wide today. Stretch, hips stay still. Abs are tight, shoulders away from the ears. 8 more, and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and bring your arms down. From here, let's just do a stretch for our shoulders. Lock your right arm in, your left arm into that right. Twist your neck. Drop the shoulders, take a deep breath in. And then let it go. And then other side. Look over to the other direction. Drop that shoulder down, draw those abs in tight. And then let it go. Thank you so much for tuning in and congratulate yourself for completing another beginner Pilates class with me. Thank you so much.